is directed by Brad Peyton and it stars Dwayne The Rock Johnson, and it's based on the classic arcade video game where you have a giant gorilla fighting a giant lizard and a giant wolf in a fucking triple threat match. And in this film, primatologist David Okoye shares an unshakable bond with the albino gorilla George, who is incredibly intelligent and he has met since birth. But after a rogue genetic experiment goes awry and transforms the gentle ape into a raging monster, two other beasts come to threaten life in the city of Chicago, and David must team up with a discredited genetic engineer to secure an antidote and fight these incredibly vicious monsters to save the people of America. So after that synopsis, you pretty much know what kind of movie you're going in. And let me tell you, this movie is incredibly stupid. I mean, this is the epitome of what a popcorn movie is. And it is all that. There are incredibly cheesy and cliche lines in this film, but the film has this incredible self-aware tone throughout. The Rock knows it, Naomi Harris knows it, Jeffrey Dean Morgan, who I'll get to in a bit, knows it. The giant monsters look spectacular, the action sequences and the CGI are incredible, and there's actually a good bit of good cinematography throughout the film. You have these incredible money shots throughout the film that are incredibly fitting to this type of film. The Rock has incredible charisma as always. This dude has a level of charisma that is equivalent to the chemistry shared by Emma Stone and Ryan Gosling whenever they're on screen. It's palpable, and The Rock has a lot of fun in this film. And there's actually quite a bit of heart when it comes to his relationship with George. The dude is completely driven throughout the film to save his friend because they are friends. He never treats George the gorilla like anything else. He's his brother, he's his friend, and he tries constantly to save him. But George goes awry, and the other creatures go awry, and it's incredibly fun to see. As I said, you can find cheesy lines and moments and beats throughout the film. The cheese is basically drooling off the screen. You can smell it, and it works so damn well. The movie understands how stupid it is, and it has fun with that throughout. So I talked about how The Rock is good, but Jeffrey Dean Morgan, this guy goes for the belt of being the champion of chewing scenery in film in 2018. I love this dude as soon as he came out on screen. Jeffrey Dean Morgan is an incredibly good actor, but he's a good actor not because he gives a good performance in this film necessarily. He's a good actor because he understands what kind of performance he must give in this type of film. That's not to say that everything works in this film. Alan Arkin plays this executive of a company that created these genetic experiments and that created the rogue animals, and she's pretty much useless, but even more useless is her brother, who is incredibly useless in this film. You take this dude out of the film is the same. And I actually like this actor. I've seen him in a couple of stuff before. I like him, it's funny, but in this film, useless. And there are a whole bunch of characters that are useless in this film. You could pretty much have The Rock or Naomi Harris or Jeffrey Dean Morgan fill the little bit of roles that some characters play in this film, and it would be the same. Joe Manganiello is in this film, to my surprise, and I really liked seeing this guy, but if you are ever going to see this film for this guy, don't. That's all I'm gonna say. The leaps of logic in this film are so gigantic that at one point, one character is shot in the abdomen, and another character references how they should be dead, which they totally should. And what is the justification for them not dying? Is don't jinx it. That's the type of movie you are seeing, people, and that's the type of movie they made and the type of movie they knew they were making. The exposition is there and it's pretty abrasive, but they actually try to be entertaining on screen as far as the visuals are concerned whenever they are spanning out exposition. I enjoyed Brad Peyton's last directorial effort starring The Rock, San Andreas. It also understood how stupid it was, but it went for the drama a little bit too much, and that's one of the main flaws with that film. But Rampage really just sticks to the fun, the stupidity, and sometimes the heart that I'm not gonna lie, it does work. This film is everything a popcorn film and a monster film should be. It is fun, it is cheesy, it is stupid, it acknowledges it is pretty stupid, and it has a lot of fun with it. I laughed from beginning to end, and I had a lot of fun with the climatic battle with all the monsters. I felt like I was watching a gigantic wrestling match, and I had the commentary in my head. If I was going to give this film a rating based on how stupid it is, and the balance with how much it acknowledges how stupid it is, this would be a fantastic Stuff the Dreams Are Made Of. But It is pretty stupid. This is one of those martinis. It is a damn good time anytime, but it's so strong of a good time, you'll get drunk right after the first sip. What did you think of Rampage, my beautiful geekies? Did you enjoy it? Did you not? Let me know if you played the game Rampage, and what was your favorite animal in the film, and what animal would you turn into a giant fighting monster if you could? Let me know in the comments below, and thank you so much for watching. I can't wait to bring you guys my review of Truth or Dare. I'm going to see it on Friday. Thank you so much once more. You geekies are the best, and so until the next review, you stay beautiful, you stay geeky, and if you haven't done so yet, click the subscribe button and the bell so you can be geeky united!